that right now, but they are expecting more snow later.
Is Santa Claus here yet?
Not yet, I'm afraid.
Come on, partner. Why don't you say we go upstairs and get some hot chocolate, warm ourselves up?
As long as we don't miss Santa.
Oh, it's no chance of that. Brian, for one, would be heartbroken. You should have heard him when they postponed the Christmas party.
Oh, yeah.
Cried like a baby. I miss
him. He did.
Good morning, Jessie.
Hi, all set up? Boardroom's almost all set up, and everything looks terrific.
Oh, great. Don't you think it's about time for Santa to get ready, too?
He's about to.
I have been elected Santa stuffer this year, and I'm going to help put the padding on this trim little tummy.
Well, that could take a long time.
Well, in that case, let's get started.
Happy holidays, Jessie.
Happy holidays. Well, hi there, young man.
Is Santa here yet?
No, not yet, I'm afraid, but any minute now, we have the most beautiful tree you ever saw, and the boardroom is all set up.
Good.
Hello.
I say we always have that.
I see that everybody's here.
Why is Santa?
He'll be here very, very soon.
I think we should all get going. We wouldn't ask Santa to think the Quartermain tribe had deserted him. Come on, guys.
Well, let's go, idea. Guys.
Merry Christmas, Lee.
Jessie, same to you and Happy New Year.
Thank you. I understand congratulations are in order, Mr. Mayor.
Yeah, it's a nice way to start the new year, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Is Gail here?
In the boardroom, yeah.
I see Alan and Monica brought the kids, but now what about Edward and Lila? Aren't they coming?
You know, I really don't know.
You're being very secretive about this.
Well, this is the first time we've ever exchanged Christmas gifts. I want it to be a very special moment for us.
Is there some particular ritual?
Yes, there is.
Yes?
First, we sit down in front of the Christmas tree.
Now, we do this even though Christmas has come and gone.
Even though.
Okay. Then what?
Now you may kiss me.
How much of a kiss does tradition permit me?
As much as you like later. We have business at hand.
All right. What's next?
Well, now we exchange presents.
And that's all there is to it?
Well, that's it. Except that you have to react with enthusiasm to whatever you get.
Well, I'm sure that I will. Okay, first, my gifts for you. One. Two.
All these?
No, they go together.
Whatever could they be?
Why don't you open them and find out?
Well, where have you been all day?
Darling, can't you guess?
Well, now, let me see. You have a glow in your cheek, a glint in your eye, an X-rated movie.
Certainly not. Really, Edward. I've been at the hairdresser's.
Since 11 o'clock this morning?
Well, the place was madness.
Oh, all the women were there getting prettied up. They say that's their biggest week of the year between Christmas and New Year's.
Mm-hmm. You never saw such a crowd.
And I don't care to either. Here, let me take your coat, darling.
Thank you, dear Edward.
Lila, darling, you're freezing.
It's cold outside.
Well, let me take you into the living room, fix you a nice hot toddy to warm you up.
I'll go in the kitchen.
No, you too, Stella. After all, it is the berry season, is it not?
Oh, how nice.
I can't believe it.
What's wrong?
Nothing.
Celia, if these aren't what you want, you know you can always return them.
No, it's not that. It's a wonderful, thoughtful gift. It's
tell me.
Open yours now.
I beg your pardon. Didn't realize the two of you were in here.
That's all right. We were just opening our gifts.
What did you get, Grant?
I'm not sure yet.
What's wrong?
Nice.
Hot toddy, anybody?
No, thanks, Edward.
I thought you'd like it.
See, I love it. I'm overwhelmed by it. It's just that...
What?
Darling, I sold my skis to get you your art equipment.
You're kidding?
No, I...
Oh, no.
Oh. You're laughing?
Well, I sold my easel and my brushes to buy the ski rink in for it.
Didn't I hear a story about this a long time ago?
Yes, I think so. The gift of the Magi, I think. It was a story about love.
See, I'm sorry, but I just don't see how we can possibly do it. We're never going to be able to rent equipment on such short notice.
But I wanted that weekend for us so badly.
I'm sorry. I would have loved it, darling. We can try, but we can't possibly ski without skis.
Edward, can I see you in the hall for a moment, please? Mm-hmm. Stella. Stella, would you make me a cup of tea, please?
Certainly.
Thank you. Poor things, they're so much in love.
Well, I must admit their sacrifice is quite touching. It's too bad they can't go this weekend.
I'm not sure about that. Edward, I have an idea.
What you doing?
Oh, I'm writing a letter to Mrs. Dodd to thank her for everything. She's been so nice to us.
Yeah, she has. I'll get the coats.
Okay.
Excuse me, Mrs. Spencer.
Oh.
Did I read your mind or what?
Yes, you did. Thank you.
Thank you.
Now we can put it on top of our Christmas tree wherever we are.
A little touch of home.
Here, why don't you put that in the suitcase? I'll get your coat.
All right, sweetheart. Well, thank you.
Come on.
All right.
It's perfect. Just married.
Just perfect.
I'm ready.
Santa just got back from the North Pole. He's got a huge bag of presents for each and every one of you. So, without any further delay, here's Santa!
Yeah! I may be a little late, boys and girls, but Merry Christmas now and every day of the year.
Happy holidays, Jesse.
Didn't expect to see you here.
Well, we really don't want anybody to know that we're here. We were leaving, and we just decided to stop by.
Yeah. We just got back from Beecher's Corners, and we were on our way, but we couldn't go without stopping here for a little bit.
Yeah. There's so many memories here for both of us.
Yeah. Do you remember the day that I hid you behind the hub?
Sure I do. You know, you know, if you ever decide to give up nursing, would you be interested in a real sleazy affair?
I'd be very interested.
I don't believe this. Come on.
Oh! Where are they telling
Let's
the Christmas story?
Let's go peek in. Come on, Mr. Bill.
You're not going to leave without saying goodbye, though, right?
No. I'll be back.
Okay.
I've got to get your number.
Even if our presents didn't work out, I still have all I want.
I just had a little conference, and we have decided to give you a very special present this year.
I don't understand.
Well, about 150 years ago, we thought it might be fun to have a little ski trip in Switzerland.
The two of us always had so much loose change lying around, so we thought it would be a good idea to put it in this piggy bank and say it was for a ski trip.
Yes, I don't know how much you're going to find in there, but whatever it is, it's all yours.
Oh, no, this is much too generous of you.
It would make us very happy if you'd accept it.
Oh, thank you so much, both of you. Well, Grant, will you do the honors?
Sure. Here goes nothing.
Oh, look at all those $100 bills.
I don't remember putting those in there.
Not a very good saver, am I?
Well, Celia, there's more than enough here for our ski weekend.
Oh, thank you so much.
And now, if you'll all
sit down and hum Joy to the World very, very quietly, Dr. Hardy will tell us the Christmas story.
Oh, oh, that's right.
Go ahead, sit down.
So you still
are
here?
Well, this is a story about the first Christmas, almost 2,000 years ago. It's also a story about a very special baby. But we're skipping ahead now to where it all happened. It was a cold, bitter winter night when the wind was blowing so hard it made tears come to your eyes. And on that winter night, a young couple was traveling on their way to Bethlehem. They were very cold and very tired. These two travelers were so poor, they had only one donkey. The man was a carpenter named Joseph, and his wife's name was Mary. And Mary was going to have a baby. But they had a long, long way to travel. Finally, after miles and miles, Joseph saw a dim light. It was an inn. And he told Mary that everything was going to be all right. So helping her along, they went to the door of the inn. Joseph knocked. And when the innkeeper opened the door, he took one look at this worn-out couple, and he knew.
They didn't have any money.
And what did he say to them?
Forget it, Joseph and Mary.
That's right. He told them he had no empty rooms and shut the door fast.
The stable?
Yes. Joseph figured at least it would be warm then. And if it would get Mary out of the cold to rest, she might still be all right. So they went to the stable. It was warm in there all right, but very crowded with animals.
Donkeys, maybe. Horses, cows, sheep.
In fact, there were so many of them that it looked like Joseph and Mary might not be able to squeeze in. Then Joseph got some fresh straw and fixed a bed for Mary. She lay down, and in a little while, a hush came over the stable. Cows didn't move. The donkeys didn't bray. And in that hush, a baby was born. They called him Jesus. And he grew up to teach us that there's goodwill in all of us, that we can all improve our lives, no matter what has happened in the past. And he taught us the most important thing in the whole world.
We should all love each other.
And we do love each other, don't we? Right here in this room, there is so much love.
What?
Just look around you. You can see it. You can feel it.
I love them so much.
Yeah. I didn't know it was going to be so hard to say goodbye.
I know. Let's just go. Okay?
Hold it. Only one second, all right?
Okay.
I have one thing. It's real important to me.
Mm-hmm.
For the road. Just to make you legitimate.
Oh. Oh, how funny. I thought of the very same thing.
Everywhere. Houston area is beginning to thaw, but the break in the freeze may only be temporary. A report this evening on Live at 5 here on 13.